Hi folks, I'm Dr. Sadie Wasatsky with the Acme Lab at Temple, and today I'm going to be showing you how to use the ContrastFEL method on datamonkey.org. So if you're not already there, navigate over to datamonkey.org, click on the Methods and Tools dropdown, and select the ContrastFEL method. Then you're going to want to choose your file. Make sure you have the correct genetic code selected, and enter your email address so that when DataMonkey is finished analyzing your data, it will email you. So today I'm using this HIV reverse transcriptase alignment, which is a dataset composed of samples from individuals before treatment, aka naive samples, and then after treatment, aka treatment samples. So because ContrastFEL allows you to compare the DNDS rates between groups of branches, you can go ahead and create a group called treatment and then select every branch that you know belongs in the treatment group. Then you can create a new selection and label that naive and select every branch that you know belongs in the naive group. Then finally, we can create a third selection called nuisance, and all of the other branches will belong in that third group. So once you've completed your selection of branch groups, you can scroll down and hit Save Branch Selection, and DataMonkey will begin analyzing the data set. So here we have the finished results for the same data set. And like every other DataMonkey analysis, you can either view the results here or you can download a JSON with the results. So you can see that I've split the branches into the three groups mentioned, naive, treatment, and nuisance. And you can see here that ContrastFEL will report the number of sites with different DNDS rates between each of these groups and which sites have a differing DNDS rate over the entire tree. Here you can also change the p-value threshold for which these sites are reported. So scrolling down, we see this ContrastFEL table, which for every site, it just reports different estimated parameters for that site. So we can actually scroll over on this table, and then looking at like the p-value for naive versus treatment, we can order that by descending and see that all of these p-values are very low, so those are going to be the ones that have evidence of differing DNDS rates between the treatment and naive branch set. And if we look over here, we can actually see which sites these are, and we actually know from previously published papers that these four sites, these top four sites here, are actually known to be involved in drug resistance with greatly noted phenotypic effects. And we can also look at the non-synonymous substitution rate at the site for just the treatment branches and then for the naive branches, and you can see how big of a difference there is there. So below this we have a basic site plot where we have the sites here, and then the y-axis can actually be whatever parameter you want it to be from this list, so you can change this based on treatment versus nuisance p-values and see how it changes versus treatment versus naive. And then you can also download those. Then we have the fitted tree, and you can see the branch groups here, and you can see how the tree is colored for each of those branch groups. And you can also save this tree if you want. And finally, we just have some information about the model fits. So I hope this was helpful. I hope you learned a little bit more about ContrastFEL. So the dataset that I used and the method will be linked below. And if you have any other questions, you can reach out on Twitter at Hyphy_software or on our GitHub issue page, which is also going to be linked in the description below. Thanks again.